the toll of the bell. Aggravated, spare for days. I troll downtown, the red light plays. Jump on, bubble up, what's in store? Love is the drug and I need to score. Showing up, showing up, hit them run. Boy meets girl where the beat goes on. Stitched up tight, can't shake free. Love is the drug, got a hook on me. Oh, catch that buzz. Love is the drug I'm thinking of.
I suppose I do play this guy quite a lot, but I've got to because he's just brilliant, and you can't play a song from 75 without playing one of these guys.
Yeah.
I'm talking about David Bowie, of course. Now, I'll have to tell you a little background what happened in 75 with Bowie.
Yeah.
From 72 onwards, he'd been glam rock, so he recorded The Rise and Fall of Ziggy Stardust and The Spiders from Mars, Aladdin Sane, Diamond Dogs, and also in there, the covers album, Pinups. Then he completely and utterly changed direction, and nobody saw this coming. He just basically reinvented himself as a soul man. Now, he goes to the United States, hooks up with John Lennon, and he also starts working with a guy called Carlos Alomar for the first time, who became one of Bowie's principal guitarists. Now, during these sessions, and you might not believe this sound, but this is true. Luther Vandross got his first big break singing on this next track.
Yeah.
Luther Vandross, I'd like to say, I know he was a great sessioner, but Bowie gave him his break.
Yeah.
And the Young Americans album is, like I said, Bowie called it Plastic Soul. Not Blue Eyed Soul, Plastic Soul. And it is soul. I don't care what everybody says, it's soul. And a lot of Bowie fans didn't know what to say because he'd just been glam rock, glam rock, glam rock. Now, Bowie just proved now he was a chameleon, he was going to change. And this song, the title track off the album, again goes out to Stuart, who again was telling me about Carlos Alomar and tells me everything about, I know about Bowie because he's the font of all knowledge.
Yeah.
And I always ask him every week, so Stuart, this is for you. But I'd also like to dedicate this to my good mate Glenn, Because Glenn is actually stuck in Germany as we speak.
Sehr gut.
Ja, das ist nicht mein Kaninchen. You know what that means?
No, what?
That is not my rabbit.
Gains in Spekmik, man.
So anyway, Glenn is actually stuck. He's been in Germany with work. He should have come home yesterday, but Lufthansa are on strike.
He
ain't going to get home now till Saturday. So Glenn and Stuart, this is for you, mate. This is the immortal David Bowie and Young Americans.
Just like you and I.
Bowie with Young Americans. Great song, that, mate.
Yeah, well, I think we've saved the best to last, I think.
Well, we've just been saying that off air, haven't we?
Yeah. A lot of people will probably agree with what I'm just this choice is. I'll give you a little background about the band. Originally called Smile, they were formed in London, I think it was in 1971. Farouk Bulsara and Roger Taylor used to run a market stall together, and I think they hooked up with with Brian May,
yeah,
lead guitar, and then they got the last member to join with John Deacon. Brian May was an astrophysics student.
Yeah.
John Deacon was studying electronics. Roger Taylor was studying dentistry, and Freddie was studying at art college. So they were quite a brainy band.
Yeah, he was, yeah.
The first album was called Queen 1. The second album was Queen 2. Didn't really do much, really. But the third album, Sheer Heart Attack, got noticed because they brought out the classic Killer Queen.
Yeah.
And that got number 2 in the charts. But the fourth album really started to get them noticed. It was called Night at the Opera. And the cover to that album, Freddie designed that himself, the Queen Crest. That was his own design. And the track I'm going to play, I think everyone knows this. What words fail me? I mean, how can you describe this song? It's
classic.
Yeah. I suppose it's like Procol Harum, White Shade of Pale. No one knows what the lyrics are about, but you don't need to, because it just works on all levels for me. It starts off as a ballad.
Yeah.
Then it goes, like Freddie said, it goes into opera.
Yeah.
Then it moves into hard rock. You know, it's just brilliant. Yeah, it's just brilliant. And when this was released, I think he gave it to Kenny Everett to play. And Kenny said, I can't play this, Freddie, it's too long.
Yeah.
So Freddie said, well, do. And Kenny couldn't stop playing it.
Yeah.
You know, and
one of them songs, though, it's an absolute classic. Well, it
got to number one, and it was number one for 9 weeks. It sold over 1 million. Then, obviously, 1991, after Freddie passed, and we should come up to the 25th anniversary of that, by the way.
Yeah.
It got number one again, and it sold another 1 million. I think it's the third biggest selling. It's the biggest selling non-charity single in British musical history. It was spent 14 weeks at number one, and it outsold Mullican Tyre as well. Now, so the only ones that sold more than this are Band Aid and Elton John.
Yeah,
you know, both charity songs, which for me don't really count because they're not bought for the musical things, are they?
No.
So anyway, last song of tonight. Of 1975 is the brilliant. Oh, before I introduce that, we'll talk about next week.
What are we doing next week, mate?
Going back to the 60s.
Yep.
1964.
Oh, brilliant year.
Yeah, so we're going to be talking about
an absolute brilliant year. Don't say why.
Go on, you were born.
Hey.
There you go. We can mention that. So we're going to talk about the British invasion of America when British bands dominated the world.
Yeah.
So anyway,
the animals.
The animals, yeah.
There is an house in New Orleans.
And the Kinks.
Yes.
Herman's Hermits.
Beatles.
The Beatles, the Stones.
I want to tell you a little story now. The Beatles went on the Ed Sullivan Show. The rest is history, mate.
Yep. So anyway, last song.
So I've got a special request for next week.
Let's
get in touch with Noddy, or get in touch with the Sounds of Salford Facebook page, or get in touch with mine, and we'll play them, won't we, mate?
Yeah, we certainly will. So the last song tonight, words can't describe this song for me. It's the brilliant Queen and the magnifique Bohemian Rhapsody.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see.